have some bad news. Someday, another asteroid is going to hit Earth, which isn't necessarily a reason to panic. Space rocks pummel us all the time, like every single day. Have you ever seen a shooting star going across the sky? That's a space rock streaking through the atmosphere. And if you can see me talking to you right now, we're still alive. For now, at least. The only time we need to worry is when the asteroid is really large, because a space rock of a certain size could wipe out a neighborhood, a city, or even humanity itself. So let's talk about how big an asteroid would need to be to do that, and which one scientists are keeping a close eye on. When it comes to asteroid tracking, there are two things that NASA scientists are concerned with: size and proximity to Earth. And that makes sense, because for an asteroid to hit Earth, it has to be, you know, near Earth. Researchers call these asteroids near-Earth objects, for reasons I hope you can figure out. There are more than 30,000 of them out there, but the vast majority are smaller than a shoebox, and they usually just burn up on entry into our atmosphere. About once a year, we get a bigger one, say, car-sized. But that's still not big enough to make it to the surface, so even those don't really pose much of a threat. And just a note, when they're in space orbiting the sun, they're called asteroids. And once they crash land on Earth, they get bumped up to meteorites. If they survive to hit the ground, that is. The odds of any meteorite hitting any one spot are super slim, about 1 in 250,000, according to one calculation. To put that in perspective, in the US, you're 16 times more likely to get struck by lightning than you are to get hit by a meteorite. So the small fry asteroids are no issue. But what about the bigger ones? A space rock the size of a football field tends to hit our planet about every 2,000 years. And when something like that crashes into Earth, it's less great. Still though, the damage is pretty localized. So if an asteroid landed in Boston, it's not that likely that New Yorkers would be affected. But once every few million years, we get pummeled by a super large meteorite, a space rock that is large enough to threaten civilization. More on that in a minute. Of the asteroids that have a chance of hitting Earth with disastrous consequences, the most likely one is called Bennu. It's a medium-sized asteroid that's going to pass near our planet in the year 2182. But astronomers seem to have a pretty different definition of what medium means. Let's use the Burj Khalifa for scale. It is the tallest building in the world, at 828 meters tall, or roughly half a mile. You know, the super tall building in Dubai that Tom Cruise scaled in Mission Impossible 4? That one. Yeah, so Bennu is about 500 meters wide at its biggest point, making it over half as wide as the Burj is tall, and that's a medium. Medium-sized asteroids like Bennu tend to hit Earth every 100,000 years or so. If Bennu face-planted into our planet right now, that would be a very bad thing. Like Game of Thrones, winter is coming, level bad. But the scale and type of badness would depend on where it struck. Because if Bennu hit land, the disaster would start with a massive earthquake. But if it struck the ocean instead, we'd get a tsunami like no one has ever seen. And either way, boy oh boy, there would be so much dust. As much as 400 million tons of dust would be thrown into our atmosphere. It could linger there for as long as 4 years, dimming the sunlight and devastating life on Earth with slow motion starvation. And if you know your dinosaur history, you might remember that when the asteroid hit Earth at the end of the Cretaceous period, it wasn't the immediate impact that killed most of the dinosaurs. They died as plants stopped photosynthesizing and our planet fell into just global darkness. And while it's not as big as the asteroid that killed the dinosaurs, Bennu could lead to a similar years-long winter. So that's a medium asteroid. Let's talk about large ones. NASA has its eye on all the really big asteroids in our solar system under a program called Sentry. Their biggest and most threatening entry right now has a pretty bland name: 29075. But it's much scarier than it sounds, because it's almost a mile in diameter. And if 29075 hit us, it's estimated that several million people would die in the zone around the impact site. For example, if it hit the Atlantic Ocean, It would impact with so much force that the asteroid would carve a hole in the sea floor, and that is 3 miles below the ocean's surface and one heck of a cannonball. Water would first flow back into the pit it left in the seafloor, and then it would spread out again in a series of circular waves. Those first few hits on the coast would seem manageable, but as more waves arrived, they would get bigger, like way bigger. And those tsunami waves would be several hundred feet high and could crash right through the largest cities on the coastlines. The highest wave would be about the same size as the cavity that the space rock carved out in the ocean, which one estimate suggests could be over 17 kilometers high. And even when the waters would recede, we wouldn't be out of the woods yet. Not only would the flood cleanup be really bad, but we'd still have the whole dust in the atmosphere issue to deal with. Whole ecosystems would be absolutely annihilated forever. People and animals would die in droves. But the key thing is that still wouldn't be enough to wipe out every living thing. An asteroid powerful enough to essentially sterilize our planet would need to be much bigger. So how big? Well, it depends. Anything from where the asteroid hits to how dense it is could alter the likelihood of a full-on life ender, but one estimate suggests any comet or asteroid that's 95 kilometers wide would be enough to turn our planet into a wasteland. If something that size were to hit our planet, scientists say the effects would be catastrophic for every ecosystem. For starters, the asteroid would generate a huge fireball that could incinerate everything within 4,800 kilometers away from the impact zone, which is, let me do some math, that's a lot of places. The whole planet's circumference is about 40,000 kilometers, so that's over a tenth of the entire planet's surface up in smoke. As the asteroid slammed into our atmosphere, it would compress the air and create the worst air blast ever, wiping out everything from cities to forests. Even the crust of our planet wouldn't survive. It would be removed or just melted, depending on how close it was to the space rock. One paper suggested that an asteroid of this size is not only enough to sterilize the planet, but to boil the oceans. Yes, boil. The upper 200 meters or so of the ocean is known as the photic zone, or the area of water that's the most hospitable to life. And a reasonably dense asteroid that is 95,000 kilometers wide, flying in at over 100,000 kilometers per hour, would be enough to turn all this water deadly hot, sterilizing it entirely. Could we hide from this kind of devastation? Unless you wanted to go off planet, probably not. The authors of this paper say that that kind of space rock would be enough for the extinction of humanity, and probably everything else with it. And there are 17 objects in our solar system that are the right size to get the job done. None of them are currently hurtling in our direction, but it's not a comforting thought. Luckily, humans have something that dinosaurs didn't have. Spacecraft. And it's not practical for all of us to get on these machines like everybody did to escape the aliens in Battlestar Galactica, but we may be able to use these spacecraft to steer bad space rocks out of the way. But before we get to that, here's a quick ad break.
Thanks to Narwhal for supporting this SciShow video. When it feels like every new robot or AI product is threatening our very existence, Narwhal is here to remind us what robots should be doing, the dirty work we don't want to do. Their next generation robot vacuum, the Narwhal Flow, breaks down tough, stuck-on dirt from your floors with its flow wash mopping system. In one pass of warm water spray, dirt and sticky stains dissolve, and it cleans the mop as it goes to kill bacteria and make every pass count. The Narwhal Flow's tangle-free feature takes care of long hair littering your floors, and the edge cleaning feature makes sure to clean every corner and hard-to-reach spot. If you have carpets, Narwhal has carpet focus tech. When it hits a carpet, the mop lifts automatically to keep it dry and get a deeper clean. And using twin AI dodge obstacle avoidance, it recognizes and avoids socks, cords, and pet toys with millimeter-level precision. It's all wrapped up in a multifunction base that washes and dries the mop. There's a reason Narwhal won Time Magazine's Best Innovations Award. These exclusive benefits last until August 27th at the link below.
Let's say that we've identified a killer asteroid. We're sure that it's gonna hit Earth, and we're sure that much of humanity is at risk. What are we gonna do about it? Our best bet is diverting the asteroid away from our planet towards something else. We're really not picky as long as it's in a not this way direction. And we've tested some of this tech in space already. In 2022, NASA launched a mission called DART, or double asteroid redirection test. The scientists involved wanted to see if they could change the direction of an asteroid called Dimorphos. It had been happily orbiting another asteroid called Didymos for eons, but when NASA's spacecraft sent an impactor towards Dimorphos, its path changed. Not much, it's still circling Didymos, but every orbit takes a little less time than before. And that's better than it sounds, because even if we can slightly divert the path of a harmless asteroid like that, it's possible that we could do the same for one that is bearing down on Earth. We might even be able to use lasers or a nuclear warhead. How we do so will take a lot of discussion and testing, but we haven't identified a world-ending asteroid that's heading our way yet, so it's all theoretical at this point. Although it may sound scary, an asteroid impact is far from the most likely culprit in ending life as we know it. Actually, we're doing a pretty good job of that ourselves. But it's nice to know that scientists are constantly scanning the solar system for rocks that might be a problem, because I, for one, do not want to get hit with something the size of a football field. Or even the size of a football.